So, jetzt und er guckt sich den Livestream gerade an.
Guten Morgen!
Alrighty, now I want some applause. Good morning! And welcome to the translation into English of the mincorrect, methodically wrong presentation at the 34th Chaos Communication Congress in Leipzig. The translation is provided by me, Miriam, Frau Blauwal and Shanks. And we always welcome any feedback on Twitter at the hashtag C3T or to at C3Lingo. And he's wondering what day it is, two or three?
Three?
I was, with the distances here, I was feeling as if day four was through and I was totally through already after day one. We had a running gag, but it died of heart attack on day one.
Zwei wunderbare Ausnahmskünstler, Obi-Wan Kenobi und Yoda.
We have two extraordinary artists, Obi-Wan Kenobi and Yoda, and the A-Team of Science, Nicolas Wöhrl and Reinhard Remfort.
Natürlich nicht. Okay.
Gut an.
Well, that's off to a good start.
Die Latte schon mal sehr hoch für den Abend.
Well, that's setting the bar pretty high for tonight.
Jetzt läuft.
Now it's working.
Ton kommt noch.
Klar, wir sind jetzt erledigt, aber wir gehen einfach nach Hause, pennen eine Runde und im nächsten Jahr sind wir alle wieder hier.
Du verstehst es nicht. Es gibt keinen nächsten Kongress.
We don't understand, there will be a next Congress. Not here. We have to go to the next Congress.
Hey Doc.
Doc, wait. Isn't Hamburg and the CCH in the other direction?
There we are going, there is no CCH. Yeah, who is it? What's going? Hey. You haven't slept, have you?
No, there's like lots of time, like, but...
You know, today at 11:30? I'm just preparing the last experiment, it will be awesome! Where will you be here?
Just 5 minutes, damn...
Geile Karre.
Doc. Cool car. Doc.
Hey, Rainy, you're here.
Of course.
Look, I found a plutonium. No one will be missing this one.
You arrived with the DeLorean?
No one cares about it. Come on, start recording.
Should I film like the entire with
first, only me.
My name is Dr. Nicolas Wurm.
My name is Dr. Nicolas Wurm. I'm here on the parking lot from the Leipziger Messe. It's 11:30.
Momentchen, Doc.
Wait a second. Plutonium? Did you clear that?
Oh, we fought them, yeah.
Direkt abgesprochen ist das natürlich.
Did we talk them? Of course we haven't, but I read the rules. They said something about plants of air and fire, but nothing about plutonium. They can't do anything.
Jesus!
Ja.
Slam.
Oh mein Gott.
Oh mein Gott. They found us. I don't know how, but I managed. They found us.
Who did, Doc?
Der Messe Leipzig.
The responsible people for the hall.
Heilige Scheiße.
Oh, holy shit.
Ich lenk sie ab.
I go and distract them.
Yeah, good.
Nein, Doc.
Oh no, Doc.
Methodisch inkorrekt, Folge
methodically incorrect. Episode 111 from the Chaos Communication Council, and with me, my well-rested traveling companion, Reinhard Remford.
Und mit mir auf der Bühne.
And with me on the stage, the plutonium smuggler of science, Nicolas Wörl.
Glück auf Leipzig!
Have fun, Leipzig!
Ja, ich sag mal so, das erste.
I'm just gonna start the first social experiment we passed. You were the control group, the experimental group. 11:30 is fairly early, and thank you for your trust in.
Just a quick question: who of you have been to the Hacker Jeopardy yesterday? Jeez, oh, you are crazy!
Wait! Have the arms up, who didn't sleep at all? Well, quite a few.
The people with children are having their head like, oh.
Wer schläft jetzt gerade?
Who is sleeping right now? We'll check later if there's more. So thanks a lot for being here. It wasn't entirely easy to put the show together here. In Saal 1, in Hall 1, there is not a lot you can do. In Hall Adams, there is even less. And so we did a revolutionarily new for us concept.
Ja, oh, da hinten verlassen fluchtartig Menschen den Saal.
We see some people fleeing the hall.
Thema und wir versuchen euch das Thema nach.
We actually have a subject and we're going to bring that closer to you, and that subject is
Presenter kaufen sollte. Das Thema ist
I've gotten a presenter.
The subject is the Ig Nobel Prize. The disclaimer, I'm going to call it Ig Nobel, I'm going to call it Ig Nobel. Americans will like to call it Ig Nobel. Ig Nobel obviously means what it does, and that's to distinguish it from the actual Nobel Prize, and it's given out for science to honor achievements that first make people laugh and then make them think. He explains that again.
I have
to add, that's not a general thing. Up to today, I think last or 2 years ago, it has been awarded to our university, the University of Duisburg. It was for a biologist. She found that dogs orient themselves at the magnetic field of the Earth. So,
hundreds of dog owners will now be walking around with compasses. One specific recipient is who I want to honor. I'll quickly check. Oh, Volkswagen got a prize in chemistry for their solution to the problem of the increased emission of bad stuff from cars by cheating, basically. To add that, Volkswagen did not accept the prize.
It wouldn't be the case that the others were better.
So the first time the prize was given out was in 91 by the journal Annals of Improbable Research at the MIT since 2012 at Harvard. And this, I guess my presenter is not working.
Es wird ja mal behauptet, ich behandle ihn schlecht.
Usually it's claimed that I treat him badly, but it's the little stings that hurt. No, it wasn't on.
So krank. Funktioniert er denn jetzt?
Is it working
now?
Oh,
no.
Doch.
Oh yes, it does.
Woohoo.
Ja, ja.
Yeah, yeah. I don't care, I got my doctor title.
So. IG Nobelpreis.
All right, IG Nobelpreis. That's a picture of, well, I don't think last year, but I don't know. But it just shows all the elements that really are relevant to this event. It's a bit special. It's kind of Monty Python meets physics humor. And I think our mix-up is better, but we'll see. I'm not going to promise too much. In the background, you can't really see it anymore, but the human curtain rod is standing because the recipients can walk through this curtain. You can see swallows because there's two segments where people can throw swallows onto the stage. This guy is the human projector holder. Maybe we can put naked people onto our stage. This is Mrs. Sweetie Pooh. That's a little girl. She always gets onto the stage when people take too long, and she gets on the stage and says, "Please stop, I'm bored." And I suppose we could try that at scientific conferences. Here it works, but at scientific conferences, I think that would be rather interesting.
Which is the same component of the statue.
Sometimes they say, we don't have a clue. So Trinkus goes in and says, let me get some kind of a number type of thing. And that's what we do. The supermarkets we kind of like. We're in trouble.
I'm bored.
What a cute little girl.
Pitch, you smash it with a hammer, it certainly behaves like a solid material. But of course, what he knew was... So are you. Actually, it's a fluid. And so, it will behave like a fluid. So am I.
Did some pretty serious research into hey, I know you're finding it hard to believe, but
sorry, I have my gag spoiled.
All right, you spoiled my gag.
Verdammt.
Oh well, crap. Spoilered. I'll try it again. We already had this kind of element before, a little less passive-aggressive. My son, 2 years ago, fell asleep and kind of told me that he was bored by that. By the way, wonderful interpretation by Bittenwon, that's now hanging in our living room. Who's asleep right now? Ooh, fewer, and not my son, which is pretty good, I guess. Let's get to the first category of this year. That's the category Anatomy 2017. We'll go back to 1991. There were 19 scientists of the Royal Society of Medicine in London, and they were thinking, we've got this incredible potential, and we've got people going to doctors every day, and they get written off sick, or they get pills, and we can use this contact between doctors and patients to do studies for tests or, you know, large-scale population studies. And they sat together and were like, so what could we study? And they thought an afternoon about it and what study they would do and how complicated that would be and who they would do it with. And they just didn't get really a result. And then one of them said, you know, why do old men have bigger ears than young men? And then they made a study and a paper, and they tried figuring that out.
Personen über 30,
they talked to people, male and female, over 30, whether they could measure their ears.
And
they did so explicitly not after serious diagnostics. So they didn't go up to someone and say, you've got one more week to live, but you've got a wonderful ear. Can I measure that? So not that, but they talked to a whole lot of people. And that's the result of the study. Age of the patient and size of ears. There is... Remford is getting...
Yes. Well, there is a linear regression, but apparently we can't fit anything to that data. I personally think to assume it's a linear regression, that's very...
That's crap. Of course you can put a linear regression there, and that's obvious, and it's 0.22 millimeters, and of course you can see ears scatter.
0.02 millimeters per year. They could measure his ear with that precision, that soft thingy on your head, and I don't feel bad to claim that as their uncertainty.
I don't know what you have hanging off your head. In this study that has been rewarded, well, since my partner is just complaining, let's look at the data. Maybe, you know, you can always check a study for relevance if you can make a good prognosis with it. And we figured, you know, if we had a being that live to 900, how big would their ears be? And the size of the ear, let's start with 6 centimeters times 900 ears times 0.22 millimeters. And, well, for this guy, that seems to work out really well. So, looks like good data.
Das kommt für diesen Kollegen ganz gut hin.
Yeah, that really fits him. So that was the prize recipient in the category of anatomy.
The nice thing about this, I would like to start the next one, but on your notebook, I can't see which one is the next slide, though.
Well, of course, you could have assumed, you know, you try it out.
You're able to use your techniques.
Nächster Preis.
Next one.
Und Herr Remford ist genauso überrascht wie ihr.
And he is just as surprised as you guys are.
Biology. There was the Nobel Prize for biology for they have found a male vagina and a female penis.
Ich war erstaunt, als ich das gelesen habe.
I was fascinated as I read it. I was like, what? Why? How? They're talking about animals in a cave in Brazil. It's talking about insects. As also kids are here, don't look.
Rule 34.
Now we have rule 34.
If you can think of it.
If you can think of it, there's porn of it.
Ach, ist das eine Scheiße?
Oh, come on, that's crap. Okay, there we are.
So, es gibt hier ein paar Details.
There are some details which can be seen. This at the bottom, that's the male one. And here at the back on the top, that's the female.
Jetzt fragt man sich so ein bisschen.
Now you're probably asking yourselves, I remember that differently. At least a little bit.
Das Ganze ist in dem, also ist ein Originalbild aus dem Paper.
That's an original picture from the paper.
Noch ein bisschen genauer angeguckt.
They have a closer look at this. And they have colored as people, animals, and they have looked at it in the microscope. And it does not really work properly.
Das Ganze ein bisschen vergrößert.
So they have looked at it on a bigger scale. On the left-hand side, you can see this on the microscope. And on the right-hand side, you can see the sexual intercourse in a schematic sketch.
Also, real porn, hentai.
So real porn and hentai.
So, das ist der Penis. Ja. Was ihr hier seht, ist auch...
What you can see here...
Auf der linken Seite.
On the left-hand side, that's the mayor. And here it has a collection of the semen. And here it is penetrated by the female with its penis. And about 70 hours.
Oh ja, ja. Und
was ist daran jetzt ungewöhnlich?
What's strange about that?
Ich will nicht wissen, was ihr bei euch im
I do not want to know what you are doing in your bedroom.
Meine Frau weint leise in der ersten Reihe.
My wife is crying silently.
As you can see here, the female's penis is bent a little bit, so it can actually get stuck to the main one. So that's often the case for animals, that the penis is actually bent, so that during the sexual intercourse there's a strong connection. So in a picture you have seen, they're actually connected at the back.
Ja, durch diesen geschwollenen
Penis. And this is actually happening with this swollen penis here. And this is so stable, they tried to take these animals apart, to separate them.
Das Hinterteil abgerissen.
So actually, it was strong enough to tear away the back part. They tested once. So in the paper they say N equals one.
Die Verbindung damit genügend getestet.
They assumed that's enough experiments of that.
Ja, was relativ selten ist, was man im Tierreich.
It's pretty seldom to see in biology. Because usually.
Das ist das Weibchen.
Usually the female.
Halt sehr gewissenhaft aussucht.
The female is looking for their partners as the cooldown is longer. So, meaning that the next time they can have kids, so for the males, they try to get to as many females as possible. And in this species, it's exactly the opposite direction.
Sich relativ schnell mit
so the females are trying to get as many males as possible.
Die Männchen versuchen sich
and the male ones are trying to get as less females as possible. That's pretty strange, though.
Biologie ist spannend.
But biology is interesting.
Genau.
Exactly. Biologie, ne? Especially this biology.
Kommen wir zum nächsten Preisträger.
All right, next one.
Der Herr Remford hat es im Podcast so schön gesagt. Es gibt so
Remford said this nicely in the last podcast. There is science where you think, oh, they're far ahead. And there is science. You think it, they're a different kind of ahead. And this is the second category. You could also say, fuck this, I'm out of here.
Man hat nämlich eine interessante Beobachtung gemacht.
There was an interesting observation in the Caatinga region in the northeast of Brazil.
Fledermäuse, Vampire.
Bats are living there, vampires, they drink blood.
Vogelblut.
Fortunately, blood of birds.
Vögeln eben.
Yeah, so they drink blood of birds.
Angeschaut, die Exkremente von diesen
Scientists looked at the excrements of these bats.
Die heißen, ich habe es vergessen.
Let's look at how they're called again. Yeah, that's
das ist der Kammzahn Vampir. Die haben sich
the Kammzahn Vampire.
Kammzahn Vampiren angeschaut.
They looked the excrements of 70 Kammzahn Vampires.
Von diesen Häufchen sehen wir Menschen.
Oh, in three of these of three of these excrements we see human blood.
Das ist insofern überraschend, als man diese Kammzahnvampire tatsächlich mal hungern hat lassen, also
so we saw human blood in the excrements of these vampires, and so
und denen dann andere Blut.
There was an experiment where they let them starve and they
und jetzt sieht man eben die
there was an experiment where they were where the vampires were starved.
Wissenschaftler gehen davon
and they tested if they wanted some other blood of some other animal.
Deren Opfer, also für die Vögel.
But finally, and they refused the blood of other animals. But apparently, humans constricted the room for this vampire so much that they looked for alternative blood and they started to go
that's a
for humans.
Nature.
So
that's
it's
a
kind of like
you take them what they're living. And then they're starting to eat all the fishes. Now we want to do the experiment.
Now we want to do an experiment.
Und wir haben gerade über Blut gesprochen.
We just talked about blood.
Weil eigentlich
may I agree? There's a classical experiment which you can do with blood.
Und eigentlich macht man das Experiment, was wir euch jetzt zeigen wollen.
And usually the experiment which we show now is done with the blood from pigs, but we are taking cares about pigs. So if you want to have a bleeding pig, that's ourselves. We take our own blood.
Exactly.
Und ich, wenn ich sage unser eigenes, meine ich...
If I say our own blood, of course I mean his.
Danke für den Applaus von einer Person.
Thank for the applause from one person.
Ja, ich lade das hier mal, Reinhard, für dich.
Yeah, I'm gonna charge this for you, Reinhard.
Wie heißen die Dinger eigentlich?
How are these things called?
Die kann man auf verschiedene Prick. Tiefen, Stechtiefen stellen. Ich stell das mal. Du hast ja eher so eine dicke Haut.
You can pierce for different depths. And you seem to have thick skin.
They actually gave that to me in the pharmacy store for free.
Was machst du denn da?
Alkohol. What are you doing?
It's alcohol, that's vacation stuff.
I thought you were going to suck on the cloth.
Actually, this hurts as fuck.
Don't be a pussy.
Ein bisschen Einsatz mal für die Zuhörer.
Livid.
Sie sind bei dir. So. Welchen Finger hättest du gerne?
Which finger you want?
Which finger would you like?
Here on the side.
On the side? Okay, look, I'm gonna count to three. Safe.
Come on, give it to me.
Ich bin ja wohl Doktor.
I'm the doctor here.
Alter.
Wieso? Cute.
Drei.
Three. I'm gonna count 3, 2, 1, 0.
Machst du das? Bei zwei erst.
Bei two.
Ja, es gibt jetzt vier Zahlen. Bei einem drücke ich.
There are gonna be four numbers. By one, I'm gonna press.
Fertig? Ja. Drei.
Three. Zwei, two.
Du wolltest kein Schweineblut nehmen.
You didn't want to take pig blood. One.
Du blutest da.
Are you bleeding?
Warte mal.
So. Wait a sec.
Wie viel kommt, da kommt, bei dir kommt ja überhaupt nichts raus.
There's nothing coming out of you.
Du bist ja innerlich so tot, wie du wirkst.
You're so dead inside, you're as dead inside as you look.
Er milkt seinen Finger.
He's milking his finger.
Ist das Zert in der Nähe?
Is the Zert near?
Ja, Reinhard, da ist er traurig.
Reinhard, this is sad.
So. Gut, wir reden mal über Ernährung.
Oh, right, let's talk about nutrition.
Ach, da oben. Da ist noch die Nadel von mir drin, jetzt, oder?
There's still a needle from me in there, isn't it? Okay, give it again. I'll try a second time.
Vielleicht hilft dir das.
I can aim, maybe that will help you.
Komm, ich mach das auch mal.
All right, let me do it. Do that too.
Ouch!
Ey, da kommt echt nichts.
There's literally nothing coming out.
Mehr trinken, genau, ja.
Drink more.
Alkohol macht das Blut flüssig, oder?
I heard alcohol makes the blood more liquid.
Applaus für das Zert.
Applaus for the CERT. CERT.
That's really sad, isn't it?
Das Zert fragt ernsthaft, ob wir klarkommen.
The CERT asks if we are okay. Never saw a show of us from us before. Now let's look at this. Look how I bleed.
Wenig Talente, aber ich blute toll.
I don't get got any talent, but I bleed well.
Tropfen tut da auch nix.
There's still nothing coming out.
Gibt's doch gar nicht. Wir brauchen doch nur einen Tropfen.
Braucht ihr einen Arzt?
Nee, geht schon. Braucht ihr einen Arzt? Fragt er nach einer halben Stunde. Ich dachte,
he's asking us if we need a doctor after half an hour.
Ihr müsst das langsam ausstreichen, das Blut muss wieder nachstreichen. Und du hast kalte Finger.
You have to squeeze the blood out slowly. Yeah.
Oh, du bist zärtlich, hör mal.
Oh, you're so gentle.
Ich bin ja auch Kinderarzt.
Okay, warte mal. I'm a child doctor.
Das wirst du nicht hinkriegen.
Das geht alles von unserer Zeit, ne?
Ja. Nee. Dann geht's schneller.
Nee, der Mann schlägt eine venöse Blutentnahme ab. Ich habe keine Ahnung, was das heißt.
The man wants to be wants to do a blood extraction. I don't know what that means. Yeah, thank you. That's enough.
Das war noch gar nicht das Experiment.
That wasn't the experiment.
Nein, was wir euch zeigen wollten eigentlich.
What we want to show you was.
Oh, warte, ich warte eben, bis der Mediziner weg ist. Bevor
in the blood. Let's wait until the doctor is out.
Wir haben ein Enzym im Blut.
We have an enzyme in the blood. At least in my blood. Not sure about his. It's called catalase.
Wasserstoffperoxid im Blut hat.
And it's very exciting because we have hydrogen peroxide
sozusagen.
Warum sollte man
Wasserstoffperoxid? Why should you have hydrogen peroxide in your blood?
Yeah. If you have hydrogen peroxide in the blood, then this, then the catalase, then the catalase will split water, hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, and both are not harmful for the human compared to hydrogen peroxide. And yeah, I'm gonna need the camera again and come closer. So
there are also two drops from my blood.
Das sind ja aber wirklich unscheinbar. Jetzt tropfe ich da mal Wasserstoffperoxid.
Now I'm gonna drip hydrogen peroxide on this. Oh, I'm shaking.
Sehr gut.
Yeah, loss of blood.
Nochmal hier, dann wir mal den jetzt Rand. Mal gucken, ob der Reinhard auch Katalase. Ja doch. Oh, guck.
Let's see if Reinhard also has catalase in his blood.
Da ist Sauerstoff entstanden.
So oxygen was created there.
Zusammen mit dem Eiweiß in unserem Blut.
And oxygen together with the.
Wie Eisschnee eigentlich. Und das ist das, was ihr jetzt da in der kleinen Schüssel findet.
Yeah, and this is bubbling.
Schweineblut.
Of course, this would have been funny with 3 liters of pig blood, but we didn't want to do this. This is why I need
Wir haben einen Alternativ. Katalysestoff gefunden.
We found an alternative catalytic product, which is called potassium oxide, iodide. And this basically does the same thing as before.
Spülmittel.
And we're going to take soap for that.
Machen wir mal hier rein in diesen Kolben.
And we're going to
put
that in there.
Ob uns den einer mitbringen kann.
We didn't have this vase, so we asked on Twitter if someone could give us one of these. And of course it worked. This only works at the Congress.
Wir hörten, Messeteppich ist nicht teuer, aber muss ja nicht
sein. We heard the carpet is inexpensive, but so you haven't do that. We haven't tested with this thing, but...
Oops.
Wir haben die billige genommen.
We took the cheap one.
Wasserstoffperoxid vielleicht für so Folien auch nicht so das Beste ist.
We didn't think about hydrogen peroxide maybe destroying the foliage, but we will see. Potassium iodide in the one bottle. And hydrogen peroxide in the other bottle. Well, we neither tried the foliage nor the bottle nor the mixture. So we did try this in the laboratory, but let's see if the scales. So it's basically the same thing we did with blood before, but
obviously not.
War doch besser als ich dachte.
Well, that went better than expected.
Mir läuft hier gerade das Iod und der Wasserstoffperoxid in die offene Wunde.
The iodide and the hydrogen peroxide are in my open wound.
Iod kennt man doch aus dem Kindergarten, oder?
Iodide, do you know
Kindergarten?
Kindergarten.
Ah, mir wird ein bisschen schwummrig, aber geht schon.
I'm a little faint, but it's okay.
Das zum Thema Blut.
Yeah, so much about the top blood topic. And about...
Das blubbert auf der Folie.
It's the blubbering on the foil. You see here?
Das könnte reagieren, also...
It might be a reaction, though.
Es gibt wenig Probleme, die man nicht mit Kleenex lösen könnte.
There are a few problems you can't solve with Kleenex. Let me through, I'm safety expert. Well, that's it.
Was denn?
Okay.
What? Mach doch mal das nächste Thema, du musst ablenken hier von dem...
Talk about the next topic, you have to...
The presenter is still not working.
Frieden. Es geht um
peace. We're talking about peace. For demonstrating that playing a didgeridoo is an effective treatment for snoring. This is an original picture from the paper. The control group from the didgeridoo playing it's not as you could think around that they have smoked a big bong. They have used a standardized plastic that you do made out of plexiglass, which could be used as a bong after the experiments.
Warum untersucht man sowas überhaupt?
Why do people look at this? Why is this important? Why is snoring an important topic?
Warum könnte es wichtig sein?
Why could it be important that people to experiment on that? Snoring means that during the sleeping you do not get enough air. So it's enough air to survive, but the sleep is very bad. So the next morning you are very tired.
Generell nicht so gut Luft und es
you can't breathe properly and you do not feel fit. Even worse, it's not for the people who is actually snoring, but for the person sleeping next to you. Actually, relationships broke because of that. And there is a wide variety of possibilities that you can suppress the snoring. This study has been due with 25 people, and the true due is a possibility. For 3 minutes, they had to practice 6 days a week for 25 minutes. That's also a point which is not so good in relationships, but afterwards they were hoping to snore again. But what did I find out? That is actually helping. It's on a significant level. The people are snoring. They have been less tired during the day.
Und ja, hat wunderbar funktioniert.
It worked very well.
Das ist jetzt nicht unbedingt die beste Lösung.
I have to add, this is not the best solution.
Die du weitestgehend akzeptiert haben.
In the paper they say the people have accepted that it's true with you. So the acceptance of the patients was very high. But the problem was, as Nikos already said, if you have to practice 6 days a week for 25 minutes, I think snoring doesn't matter anymore. So there are other possibilities.
Das mit dem Schnarchen in den Griff zu bekommen. Und zwar, ich habe das Ganze mal Snore Wars genannt.
I have called that Snore Wars. Und, the Wars in a Relationship. And this has also a subtitle. The Return of the China Gadget.
Wie ihr euch denken könnt,
as you could imagine, China Gadget, there is more than one China Gadget which should suppress the snoring.
Professionell, wie ich finde,
for the first one, there's also a very professional advertisement video. It takes about 6 minutes. We won't watch the same whole. It's an instruction how to use it. I have it with me, and Mr. Ware is allowed to test it.
Wait, what?
Um es vorwegzunehmen, ich habe nicht ein.
And to say it once, and it only have one China Gadget. I have three of them.
Starte mal.
In der Zeit. Sorry. Meanwhile, I'm going to look for them.
It's as easy as it is comfortable.
Das könnte von Apple sein.
An independent dilation system allows for subtle adjustment from one nostril to the other, ensuring optimal airflow. To get the best fit, with clean hands, hold mute by the bridge, with the curved arms facing towards you. Place the curved arms into your nostrils first, so they make contact with the inside floor of your nose.
Wir sind es ja auch gewohnt, gelegentlich mal so Auftragsproduktionen zu machen. Ich frage mich, was dieser.
We're used to having to do, you know,
dann auch noch so drücken.
Custom products, but we were wondering what this guy was thinking, why he was doing that. We'll stop. He explains how to vary it in size and all, and I, of course, spared no expense and ordered that, and it didn't get stuck at customs. It's actually nicely packed away. Actually, do you have...
No.
Does he have snoring problems, Rosie? She says, well... So probably yes, yeah.
She's professionally lying. This doesn't look like in the ad.
No, that's impossible.
Die China Variante davon.
It's the Chinese variant of it.
Ich habe noch was auf Peroxid dann in Händen.
Soll ich dir das in die Nase probieren?
Vielleicht nicht.
Maybe not.
Bis zum Anschlag.
Oh, ich habe you know, all the way.
I didn't cut my nose hair. Please not from exactly below. Are you happy with this application?
No, it has to go really all the way. It has
what?
To hit the bridge.
This is hurting.
Can you imagine this? Is that uncomfortable? It should help.
I'm gonna say punk's not dead.
Well, snoring causes the soft palate when excitation and of breathing, it starts to oscillate, and that's what the snoring happens. And this thing keeps your nose open, and therefore you will be able to always breathe through your nose. And sure, maybe it's uncomfortable, so maybe it doesn't really stay there.
Staying in there properly.
Jetzt ist es, glaube ich, tiefer reingerutscht.
Now it went in deeper.
With the one or other China shop, there is actually a category of snoring, and I found something else there. That thing is kind of okay, but these are my two personal highlights, and this is for putting in your nose again, and it's an air purifier. And the nice thing really is the packaging, because take a look at this picture. You can hardly see it. I put it in the presentation for that again. The air purifier. That's what's on the back of this. And well, I wonder. Yeah, I know. Snoring is nice, but these shocked faces in this group. Again, this is a thing for applying to your nose so that you can breathe freely and not snore.
Noch zusätzlich zu dem, was ich eh schon in der Nase habe.
Additionally to what I already have in my nose.
No.
Oh, please.
This one is soft, and you will probably sound extremely stupid. Amazingly comfortable. Great. So comfortable.
Eine leichte Note von PVC.
A hint of PVC. It's fucking gross. So, I mean, the best thing was this packaging. And if you look at this picture a bit more closely, if we could have that on the screen. The picture?
Yeah.
So, if you see this child and all the people, and it looks... it looks shocked, and the hearts look kind of more like blood presses. And I think one of these guys has a hammer. Wow, they really made a shooting for this China gadget? Can't be. So I did Google reverse image search. Where might this be from? And I actually found it. And it's actually from a remake of Stephen King's The Mist.
Großartig, oder?
Also, that's amazing, isn't it? So much about copyright. Who cares?
Although the man with the hammer reminds me of my wife in the morning.
There's one last thing. These two were really to support your breathing through the nose. But they don't really prevent you from breathing through the nose, which is kind of problematic. And here's China gadget number three. Hold on to this for a second. If you wonder how this is applied, here's the picture. Here you go.
Was soll dieses Ding bewirken?
What is this supposed to do?
Eng, genau, eng rum.
You have to put it really, really, really tight.
And
this is for keeping your mouth shut while sleeping. Snoring isn't a problem. You've got four options. Two filters for the nose look like you've got mumps, or play didgeridoo. So much for the Peace Ig Nobel Prize.
Schatz, komm, gib mir einen gute Nacht Kuss.
Come on, honey,
please give me a good night kiss.
So. Okay, darf ich es ablegen oder?
Ja, du darfst es ablegen.
Yeah, you can put it away.
Was ist denn das nächste Thema?
So, what's our next subject?
Besser vorbereitet ist als ich und nicht gucken muss.
Since you're better prepared than me and don't have to look.
The next topic is amazing.
Im nächsten Thema habe ich etwas gelernt.
Next topic.
Über uns beide mal wieder.
While studying for next topic, I learned something about the two of us. We're middle class scientists. That's not surprising for the audience, I guess.
Wir hatten mal ein Experiment.
We had an experiment. I'm going to say it like this, Reinhard. One of our experiments was a classic.
Oh crap, now I know what's coming.
Ein Klassiker. Die In-Ear-Löffelglocke.
The In-Ear Spoon Bell. Wait, no,
which is
I don't
a classic.
Hab, dass wir beide, Reinhard, Dinge nicht zu Ende denken.
Where I noticed that the two of us don't think things through all the way to the end. The in-ear spoon bell works like this. We have a spoon on a band. This is a band from Christmas Presents, but that's not important. And Ramford is going to wrap this band around his finger, and he's going to stick these fingers into his ears. And if he's knocking with the spoon at a table, then you're not going to hear anything. But
it sounds like bells.
But for Ramford, it sounds like a bell.
You can test that.
You can try this, especially the children. And why is that? Well, that's because the sound is very well channeled through the bones, and especially through the skull. And you have an in-ear headset effect.
Und deswegen klingt der Sound so bassig, so satt und so laut.
And there is air in your ears, and this air starts oscillating, and this is why this sound has a lot of bass in your head.
And we asked them to send us pictures.
Also vielen Dank dafür.
Our listeners did this, and we asked them to send pictures, and here are some of these pictures, and we still get pictures from our listeners. And I introduced
Reinhard, wir denken Dinge ein.
I introduced as we two don't think things through all the way to the end. This is a nice experiment, but of course there are applications for this experiment. And one of these applications is the Ig Nobel Prize in the category birth help. And one of these is the facial expressions of fetuses to vaginal intravaginal music emission, and you can guess about the story. You can guess the story. One of the PhD students came in, and I asked him, "Do you have time?" And he said, "No, I'm googling dildos. Google dildos with."
Man muss zu all diesen Preisen sich auch immer wieder ins Gedächtnis.
With all these prices, you have to keep in mind all of these prizes that have been given. Somebody published a paper in a scientific journal.
Here there was also a paper, and the scientists could show that abdominal music, so that means a headset on the abdomen, leads to a reaction of the fetus starting at the 26th week, but intravaginal, the reaction starts at the 16th week. So the scientists say that you should start with the intravaginal music early to, I don't know,
früh schon mal Reize zu setzen.
Und Ramford, to teach the children early. And Ramford, I bought something.
No,
just a joke. But yeah, here we see that we're bad scientists, or at least we don't think things through all the way to the end. Or at least we're bad businessmen, but because the scientists, of course, didn't only write the paper, but they also filed a patent for this musical dildo. I'm gonna call it like this, musical dildo. And I looked through the internet a bit more, and oh, I found a website about this.
Does that thing exist with Alexa and Google Home and all that?
The thing is called Baby Pod.
Sehr, sehr sympathisch. Baby Pod, das einzige Gerät.
Very, very nice. Baby Pod, the only device that can improve the articulation of the unborn baby through music. And I scrolled down, child and mother united through music. And look, it's a video. Yeah, let's watch this video.
Danke. Es lohnt auch.
It's worth it.
Hauptdarsteller, man könnte meinen, Hauptdarsteller ist die Mutter oder das.
Main actor is. You would think the main actor should be the mother or the child, but the main actor here is actually, I think, the husband, who looks very sad. He cannot communicate with his unborn child, and that makes him very sad. And as soon as his wife is vaginally is wired vaginally, his mood improves.
Music stimulates the baby before birth. This is a scientific fact. But how to convey the musical stimulus in the same way that we cannot hear what is going on inside? The baby cannot hear what is happening outside. This is also a fact.
Das tut richtig weh, muss ich sagen.
Really, really hurts seeing that.
We can stimulate the baby. 3D ultrasound scans demonstrate this. Once your child can hear the music, the baby's brain receives a stimulus that provokes and encourages a response. The miracle of phonation starts prematurely, key to cognitive development. Look how the baby sticks out its tongue. And you can't wait to talk to your child, to tell your baby how much you love him and see how he reacts. What if we could start now? Give your baby a universal stimulus. Send him a message from before birth.
Ich find's geil, was wir als Menschheit leisten mittlerweile.
It's kind of amazing what humankind can do these days.
Science.
This in science, it works.
Ich warte auf den ersten Tag, wo ich ihn
mit der Barbe. I'm gonna wait for the first day where somebody sits down in front of me in the train and puts this on the table. Just a sec.
Right?
Ich frage mich auch, also.
I wonder. Yes, of course, communicating with the kid is good, but you can overdo it, right? At which opportunity can you use this?
In the video, watching this video, I asked myself if the child doesn't even want that. Maybe it's screaming, silence, silence. Well, I have to admit,
just imagine your kid is born and it's singing Breathless. German Schlager Song was a hit this year.
Ich bin ja ein großer Freund der Live-Musik.
I'm a big fan of live music.
Und ich sag mal so, warum sollen wir
say it like this?
Kindern vorenthalten?
Why should we not show this to unborn children? And there I saw I found the YouTube channel of BabyPod.
Vaginalkonzerte.
Vaginal concerts.
Hätte ich auch nicht gedacht, dass ich so ein Wort mal auf einer Bühne sage. Von 3000.
I wouldn't think that I would. I never thought that I would say a word like this on the stage.
Ja. So viel zur Kinderfreundlichkeit von Minkorrekt um 11.30 Uhr.
So much to child friendliness of Minkorrekt at 11.30. Vaginal concert, a new idea of BabyPod from BabyPod.
Is included in a very special concert by Soraya. To welcome Christmas, that a group of mothers and future babies were able to attend.
Stand da Sekt auf dem Tisch?
Ja, glaubst du, das machst du nüchtern?
You think you do this without being under the influence of alcohol?
This is the first concert for fetuses ever made in the world.
Today, it is vaginal concert. For the first time, the fetuses have had the opportunity to quit the soundproof environment they live and listen to Christmas song.
For the mothers, this show was a whole new experience that allowed them to feel and share the songs with their unborn babies.
Well, actually, it was the first time I experienced it. It was
unique. Soraya, the singer, undoubtedly won't forget this show.
I've never been performing for such a young audience, so for me it's been a
great show. It is safe and easy to use. It is placed like a tampon and connects to the smartphone. It is a revolution in gynecology.
Wie abgezockt muss man eigentlich als Künstler sein, um zu sagen, ich habe noch nie vor so jungem Publikum gespielt?
How sad do you have to be as an artist to say I never played in front of an audience so young? And as a musician I'm kind of...
Die Vaginaltrommel, das ist vielleicht ein Produkt fürs nächste Jahr.
The vaginal drum, that would be a product for next year.
Wir sind gerade bei Musik. Erinnert
We're talking about music right now. Do you remember this?
Dass ihr Mate trinkt und immer Fefe lest. Gefiel uns eure arschlochfreie Zone ohne Vorurteile oder Homophobe. Gefällt uns diese fast perfekte Welt, auch wenn sie wieder nur 4 Tage hält. Gefiel uns viel zu klein der Laden. Wo bis als nächstes hin, dürfen wir euch das fragen? Ja. Das geht an das Sorgateam. Es gefiel uns. Danke, das war's. Wir waren gern wieder da. wollen uns daher bedanken.
Wir ja, ist ganz vorbei.
CCH, wir sind raus hier. Danke, das war's. So schön sie auch war. Ihr könnt uns gerne begleiten.
Da klatscht einer mit.
Danke, das war's.
Ja, das war, das haben wir in der Closing
Session. That was the closing session from last year.
Unser Podcast ist ja auch bekannt.
Our podcast is kind of famous for qualitatively high music.
And of course we know that you always press on skip if music appears.
But here you can't.
The only situation where you do have to suffer through this is of course when we sing ourselves. And the song made sense, so at least if you look at the text. And of course we liked the Congress, but musically we were in over our heads.
We recorded us in our lab next to the airflow.
Yeah, and that's not the worst thing.
I think that was the first time I was really ashamed on
and
stage.
That means something, talking about us.
So how about this?
Right, not from translators. We might try to translate this as best as possible, but this is going to be hard. So then,
we come
out of the
Sorry, just enjoy.
Never mind, no chance.
Heute grandios Experimente, der Brandschutz wird schon langsam bleich. Sind das Update, Bicorec 2.1. Wir wollen was abfackeln, sprengen, doch der Saal ist zu klein. Die Nobelpreise haben wir deshalb heute euch dabei. Der Tech-Review sortiert die skurrilsten Themen von uns
komprimiert,
um sie wiederzugeben. So kamen wir zum C3 in Hamburg, die 31, zum ersten Mal dabei. Jetzt sind wir hier in Leipzig, massig Platz in Messerhallen, Raum für etwa 15.000. Dicken Dank ans Orga-Team, dass wir hier sind. Hey, alles glänzt, so schön neu.
Hat sich das auf der anderen Seite der Monitorboxen genauso schlimm an?
Wie es uns hier gefällt, so neu.
Was ist das nächste Thema von dir?
Hamburg mit Staub bedeckt, in Leipzig geht es weiter. Dank der Community fällt uns der Umzug leichter.
Ich hör mir mal den Sound an.
Wow, alles klingt so schön neu.
Besser hier, oder?
Okay. Besser.
Die Engel sind auch mitgekommen, um mit euch den Kongress zu rocken. Helfen da, wo Hilfe fehlt, Ehrenamt ist nicht zu trocken. Pock und Nox sind aufgebaut, Daten fangen an zu fließen. Die Sicherheit liefert das Pferd an Bockenhitten schon. Harte wurde herangetan, kalte Stellen konserviert. Schon von hoher Qualität wird durch das Bock garantiert. Soll doch was fehlen, dann schaut einfach kurz beim Rock vorbei. Ganz egal, was es auch ist, die Zaubern ist für euch dabei. Die Lounge steht ein, um am Sort zu tanzen. Niemand bleibt allein, jeder ist Teil vom Ganzen. Scheißegal, wer es ist, jeder ist hier willkommen. Auch wenn du anders bist du hier ernst genommen. Chaos Communication Congress, bessere Realität. Wir würden gern für immer bleiben. Schade, dass es noch nicht geht. Hey, alles brennt, so schön neu. Mann, wie es uns hier gefällt, so neu. Hamburg mit Staub bedeckt, in Leipzig geht es weiter. Dank der Community fällt uns der Umzug leichter. Das CCH ist weg, auch wenn wir es vermissen. Ist Leipzig auch ganz nett, das sollen alle wissen. Hey! Alles glänzt, so schön neu.
Das wissen wir zu schätzen, dass ihr sitzen geblieben seid.
We really appreciate that you stayed for this.
I expected a slow clap.
Nein, alles gut.
Everything's fine.
Wo waren wir?
Where were we?
Wo waren wir? Hier.
Physics. Physics.
Jetzt kommen die spannenden Themen.
No, there are the interesting topics. Physics.
Herr links, wer kennt den?
The man on the left hand side. Who knows what is this? Shame on you.
Das ist, wo sind meine Notizen?
This is, where are my notes?
Ein alter Grieche.
It's an old Greek guy.
Heraklit war es, glaube ich.
It was Heraklit? It was Heraklit. From Ephesus.
Somebody says, shame on you.
Weil Platon und so den auch noch.
He stated the sentence. Everything is flowing.
Ja, alles fließt.
Yes, true, everything is flowing. So, what do the physicists look like? The thing on the right-hand side, cats.
Sind ein paar Physiker der Frage nach.
Some physicists were interested in the question, is a cat a fluid?
Eine Katze ein Festkörper?
Or is a cat rather a solid? That's apparently a very difficult question.
Man könnte jetzt einfache Definitionen von Festkörpern.
One could now use very simple definitions from solids, liquids and gases. And a very simple definition would be something like a solid state is a body which has a constant volume.
Ja, konstanten Volumen und
a constant volume and a constant dimensions. So it stays as it is. A liquid on the other hand.
Etwas mit einem konstanten Volumen.
Something which has a constant volume, but it's actually changing its shape corresponding to that volume it's in. So a gas is something which is just expanding the whole space.
Das ist eine einfache Definition.
That's just a very simple definition.
Jetzt kann man mal gucken, ob das auch für Katzen zutrifft.
Now we can see if this also fits for cats. And these people who have done these experiments, they have investigated the questions and they have reformulated the question because someone has asked in the internet, a cat could be a liquid. And this was the question they wanted to answer in the paper, and the definition was, following these common sense definitions, a meta study entitled Are Liquids was recently published on boardpanda.com.
Wer kennt's nicht?
Who doesn't know it? I promise you to check if the pandas claim that the cats are liquid is solid.
Fand ich sehr schön.
I really like that one. By using the tools of modern reology. What is reology? That means rheology. This is the science about flowing. I didn't know it actually exists. It was also published in a journal which have been made by the Society of Rheology. So it's bulletin news from the Society of Rheology.
Ich dachte schon immer, der Wachturm wäre ein
Spaten. Also, der Wachturm was a strange thing.
Die haben sich auf jeden Fall ein bisschen genauer angeguckt. Okay,
das. They looked at this in detail. So they tried to experiment, scientific experiments, just to say it fills the space. You have also to take into account the maths. So we are already doing a little bit of maths, but it's not that much. It's just one equation. But before I start with the equation, I would like to show you the slide I forget about. This definition, something is actually falling in their space, but it's very difficult for fluids and solids. That's an experiment from 1930s, you can see here. There was this material filled in this cone, and then in the 1930s they were opened that out and it was flowing through. And I was observing, one dropping filling down from this highly viscous liquid. So every 8 years, a drop fall down. So now is the question, is this a solid or is it a liquid? Because it's flowing, sort of. But if you do not look, it's not flowing. So you have to watch it for 8 years to actually observe the flowing. So if something is a liquid or a solid, it's also depending on the time you actually look at it. So how long is your observation?
Kann man mathematisch sehr
and this can be interpreted mathematically.
Kann man eine Variable einführen, DE?
We can state a variable, it's called DE.
Wofür das Ganze
steht. I forgot what it says. It's a Deborah number.
Und hat oben Tau, die Relaxation.
We have here Tau, it's relaxation time. At bottom, it's big T, it's the observation time. So the time of the experiment itself. So with this definition, we now can actually describe if something is a liquid or a solid. So the relaxation time is the time which something takes to actually fill the space. For example,
Wir nehmen Wasser, schütten
With,
das in ein
Glas. We have water and pour it into a glass. It is immediately filling out the space. So the relaxation time is very short. If you now have something very viscous, like a pudding, it takes a while until it's really filling the space. So the relaxation time is lower. T is the time which we are observing the experiment. If you have something now, if this number is on the left hand side, it's very big. So whereas the relaxing time is much bigger than the observation time, then you can say it's a liquid because it's not flowing. But if this number now is which is smaller than one, so if the observation time is much bigger than the relaxation time, then we can talk about a liquid or even for a gas. So depending on how small the number. So if it's less than one, it's a liquid. That's a mathematically very nice description if something is a liquid or a solid. Now we have to take into account, if a cat is a solid or a liquid, we have to actually determine the relaxation time of a cat. So how long does it take for a cat, in average, to actually adjust the environment? And is it actually doing that? And yes, it does. Here we have some pictures from the paper.
Und zwar, das ist, ich glaube, Cat Bounce heißt das Ganze.
I think it's called Cat Bounce. There is the observation time really short. It's bouncing from the sides and it's a solid. That's what they say in the paper. But there are also other possibilities. For example, if you look longer than that, then you see.
Dass ich Katzen, Katzen und ich bin ja Besitzer eines dicken Katzen.
I also own a cat, a very fat cat, so I live with it.
Dass sich Katzen,
that cats actually have a strong tendency that after a long time, that also when they're very small, are adjusting the environment.
Wenn man eine Katze lang genug beobachtet,
so if you look at the cat long enough, you can see the cat is a liquid. How long? So how long do we have to look at the cat? They have looked at different cats and they saw that the average relaxation time of a cat is about 1 second.
Wenn die Katze in der Nähe halt dieses, ne, also
if the cat is close, also if the cat is actually starting to get into that sink, it's in 1 second later, it's actually filling the space. So we can observe the cat as a liquid.
Es gibt noch viel mehr Effekte.
And there are even more effects.
Lassen, dass eine Katze eine Flüssigkeit sein könnte. Und zwar Sachen, die wir bei Flüssigkeiten halt auch betrachten.
Things we also observe for liquids. For example, it's a capillary effect.
Wenn ihr einen dünnen Spalt habt,
if you have a really narrow slit and you fill in liquids or water, then the addition of the surface, the water is stuck there. So the same can be observed for a cat if they fall into a narrow slit. At a certain point, the surface tension is broken and the cat falls down.
And now you're just going freestyle, or is that still from the paper?
Wait a sec, this is not from the paper. Because the picture from the capillary force. The source was labeled as Facebook, facebook.com. That was one step ahead, source internet. Okay, these are again original pictures from the paper. Here you can see a cat again. This cat is placed, for what are you talking about, hydrophobe or hydrophile? In the paper they have used the word superphalidophobic.
Also Phelia ist ja die Katze.
So Phelia is a cat.
Und das ist eine katzenphobe Oberfläche.
So apparently that's a strongly cat repellent surface.
Also an dem hohen Kontakt.
You see that from the high contact angle from the cat to the surface.
Weitere Effekte.
Other effects which have cats in common with liquids. There are surfaces
wo Katzen quasi
where the cats are repelling from. For example, water. So it's not working. Or on the other hand, adhesion forces. There are surfaces where cats are actually sticking to, and they are slowly going down, just pulled by the gravity.
Oops. Das war. Und um euch ein bisschen zu zeigen,
so now to show you that effect, so that solids can also be liquids, we have one two little experiments.
Ich weiß gar nicht, was wollten wir alles machen? Ach, so
I can't remember what else. Okay, that's what we start with.
Zwei Plexiglasscheiben.
We have here two plates made of plexiglass, which we have stuck together.
Mit einem kleinen Abstandhalter. Wo ist denn der Trichter?
Also ja,
da ist der Trichter.
And there it is. And what I have here is a mixture from
Poppy.
In
a mixture of poppy in two bags.
We have actually tried that in the kitchen of Mr. Byrne. I had to clean afterwards twice. I was forced to.
Was ihr hier seht, ist eine Mischung aus aus Mohn und Salz.
This is mixture. And we are now pouring it very slowly. That will be a mess.
It's a mixture of poppy and salt. And we're going to pour it through this.
No. It's going to work. So, okay. Now I'm pouring this into this mixture.
Also im Moment fließt.
So currently this is flowing, this mixture. So right now you should be looking at it rather as a liquid. But it's starting to form this kind of mountain, which shows us that it's obviously not a liquid. As soon as it rests, it becomes a solid. And you see another thing rather nicely. And it's getting better. You can see this sort of parallel lines, right? We can see a demixing. We had a poppy salt mix, and sometimes you can see it better, but you can see it here already, these parallel lines, because the poppy is a bit more coarse and it builds a coarse sieve, and the sieve goes through the poppy sieve and you get these layers of salt, and then you get another poppy sieve layer, and so they one by one they change. And you get this nice pattern that becomes a nearly demixed solid.
Why do you put that much
solid
of that into this? But now you can see very nicely how this works.
Genau, das war also auch ein eigentlicher Festkörper, der sich aber in Form von granularer Materie.
So we have seen that's a solid, but still it acts like a liquid. So it's flowing. And then it can demixture itself. We have something else to show you. So where is the cylinder now?
Ich such mal. Hier.
Ah, da.
Einmal ein.
Okay, there it is.
Wir haben hier noch ein Glaszylinder.
We have here a cylinder made of glass.
Mit sehr, sehr feinem Sand.
We are now going to fill that with sand.
Wir haben keine Kosten und Mühen gescheut und 25 Kilo Vogelsand.
We have bought 25 kilograms of this sand here.
Wir füllen hier mal. Ups.
So I'm filling this sand into the tube.
Wenn Festkörper in so einer granularen Materie, also
as soon as solid are in the state of this granulates, they have some very interesting properties, because sometimes they are solids and sometimes they are liquids. If I now have this thing and I push it into it, so this is done very easily with a little bit of screwing. And now if I'm trying to make it a little bit narrow,
wenn es locker ist, komplett nach unten durchschieben,
then I can actually put it to the bottom. It's like it's a solid.
Ein bisschen Sand einfüllen.
Let's add a little bit more.
Ich könnte jetzt sehr, sehr leicht.
I could now easily take this out.
Geht halt super leicht wieder raus.
It's very easy, just as in a liquid. But as soon as you dance it a little, I forgot something. I wanted to show a YouTube video, but doesn't matter. Does anyone know if you Kranplätze müssen verdichtet werden? Just as a German joke.
Jetzt seht ihr, warum Kranplätze.
So now you see why this has to be done.
Nichtskönner.
It's spaces where cranes are put. They have to be
densified. Because they're not part of the European Union.
Wenn man jetzt diesen Sand verdichtet, dann ändert
sich der so the properties are just changed. So if I'm trying to take this out, if I now push that again,
as
I'm hitting
so
this,
because if you shake the sand, it's concentrated. So compared to
Mehl, kann man durch Druck verdichten.
For flour, it's usually done by pressure. What am I doing here all by myself?
Ich komme mir vor wie bei den Lesungen, wo ich gegen die Bierdose schnitze.
I feel like if I get teaching a lecture where I snip against a beer can.
Mach nicht kaputt.
Don't break it.
Is it borrowed or is it ours?
Ich frage mich, was für dich mehr wert hätte.
I wonder what would be worth more to you.
Das Ganze hält jetzt extrem gut, weil der Sand halt verdichtet
ist. This is still holding because it's compacted.
Beim Rausziehen.
So if I'm pulling it out, it's actually pressed in. And now, if you pull, apply enough force, you see, we have sand.
Ja, nicht so richtig entscheiden kann, ob er jetzt Festkörper
sein. It actually can't decide, is it a solid or a liquid.
Wir haben hier noch einen kleinen Kompressor gekauft.
We have here also a little compressor.
Und ich muss mal kurz gucken. Und haben hier zwei Bälle.
Here we have two little balls. We have another nice experiment.
In den Eimer.
Man kann nämlich mit manchen Sachen sehr schön zeigen, dass sich Sand auch wie eine Flüssigkeit verhalten kann.
With some nice experiments you can also show if sand is a liquid if it's moving enough.
Bist du mal, sagt er zu 25 Kilo, die ich hier.
So,
stopp. Ist rein,
stopp,
oder?
Stopp.
So. Is enough.
Dann packen wir hier in die Mitte einen.
Then we put this ball in the middle.
Weiter.
Okay, continue.
So, stopp. Wir haben jetzt hier einen Eimer voll Vogelsand.
So, we have here the sand. In the middle, there we have a ball with a very low density. It's just a plastic ball. That's an experiment we haven't tested yet.
Und haben hier eine gute Stahlkugel.
And here we have this ball of steel.
Die natürlich auf diesem Festkörper hier.
So, we are going to place that on top of the solid.
Luft da rein.
If you are now going to put enough air, this sand is going to behave like a liquid. This goes also on a big scale. Is this enough pressure? Yeah, just try it.
Achtet mal auf die Kugel, was passiert, wenn wir jetzt.
Watch the ball. If I now put in the air.
Okay.
Man hat es blubbern gesehen und die Kugel ist untergegangen.
So you see, the ball has disappeared. If we would have more time and a better compressor, the other ball will also come to the top. Maybe I can find it. So the ball made of steel is... where is it? I can't even find this one.
Die Stahlkugel ist locker.
So the ball is actually more deeper than the length of a hand. So sand can also be a liquid. One can do that also on a bigger scale, so it's more spectacular. We haven't been able to do that, but we have found a video. So we wanted to show you this, where sand is actually behaving like a liquid.
Das Schöne daran ist, das funktioniert nur so lange, wie genug Luft dadurch fließt. Sobald man die Luftzufuhr ausmacht, ist das Ding wieder ein Festkörper. Und Nikolas sagte gestern so, als Vater würde er, weiß ich nicht, ob man die Kinder darin tauchen lassen sollte, wenn dann plötzlich der Kompressor mal aus ist. Ich weiß ja nicht.
Kommt ein bisschen drauf an, ob man neue braucht.
Ja. Maybe it depends on whether you need new kids.
Wenn ich das Planschbecken aufbaue.
My son gets a little unruly when I put up the kiddie pool.
Ich find's schon geil, dass das Ding allein so blubbert.
I really like the blowing.
Da ist so der Moment, wenn man da falsch abschaltet, die Luft.
That's the moment where if you turn that off the wrong way.
The effect that this thing becomes solid. It's really heavy. So this ball of steel, you cannot easily take that out anymore.
Habt ihr das Kind gesehen?
Have you seen a kid which was trapped?
Aber ich finde ja, das wäre.
But really, I think that would be a really nice community project for the Camp 2019.
A sand pool.
Okay, kommen wir zum.
All right, let's get to the next one. That's medicine.
Ein Thema, was mich auch.
A subject which personally has been keeping me busy.
Abneigung gegen Lebensmittel. Das ist meine Tochter.
Dislikes of food. That's my daughter. She currently eats dry rice, potatoes, noodles, nothing with sauce, as you can see on this image. dislikes of food have really are really under researched because there are too few medical studies of it. Of course, there are things we all hate.
Leicht fragwürdig,
but it's ethically questionable if you put criminal if you feed that to criminals. There are enough cantinas, so you could test that. It's a little bit tricky. So in this paper, they searched for a model substance that they found and. They got the prize for the application of the functional MRI to determine the extent of the dislike that people have against cheese. And you can see different cheeses and different kinds of other foods, and there is a significantly larger dislike towards cheese than towards other foods. And a certain percentage of the population just dislikes cheese. Can I see some hands? Yeah, well, it's probably underrepresented in here.
I have to ask a question.
Auch auf Pizza.
With dislikes cheese also on pizza. So cheese and metal cheese is not the same thing.
Veganer Käse.
Vegan cheese.
Was sie noch gemacht haben,
also right, well, the other, they didn't just put cheese in front of people and made them eat that and try to figure out whether people liked or didn't like that. But they also did MRI scans and looked at that and looked if they could see regions in the brain that are particularly active when people dislike food. And yes, they found something. There are regions that you can see, and now you can quantify disgust, really. We get to this disgust later. It's a nice opportunity for an experiment.
That's what I was afraid for.
An experiment which we're doing on us, by which I mean him, Mr. Remford. I brought two cheeses.
Both of us could do this.
Well, oh. Well, one of us has to stay in working condition. And besides, hey, that's my revenge. I got that cheese. And I had to transport that in my car. So, you know, on the Autobahn we stopped several times to check if one of us had filled their diaper.
It's smelly.
Das riecht auch hier jetzt schon.
Warum hast du auch so große Dreck genommen?
Why did you buy the big ones?
Niklas wollte das.
I have to admit, Niklas first wanted that both of us are eating this.
Ja, so stehe ich zu meinem Wort.
Boah, das ist.
Oh, come on.
That's how I keep my word.
Und er hat gegoogelt nach den schlimmsten.
And he has googled the worst cheese existing.
Nach Käse, die noch legal sind.
Cheese which is legal. There's there are types of cheese, or there are in Germany, or also in the whole European Union, which is illegal.
I actually need a knife. I don't want to touch that with my with my fingers directly. So, are you very hungry or?
No.
In der ersten Reihe riecht man das schon, oder?
You can smell that in the first row, right?
Yeah.
Is that about the right size?
Oh.
Ich sag mal nicht auf. Aufessen ist nicht nötig.
I'm not gonna force you to eat up.
I try it.
But you have to try. The trying is kind of the important thing. And they had a quantification here, and you can just say I think it's disgusting. I'm one of these 6%. I don't like cheese.
Sagen wir mal einen gewissen Druck erzeugen.
Let's see if we can add some pressure so that you really do your best. And since I don't have a tomography machine here, electroshocks might be the right thing for you. So I got this device.
I know where it is.
Ich helfe dir mal.
I'll help you.
Eigentlich bin ich ja der weniger Angst vor Stromschlägen.
Usually I'm the one which is less afraid of electric shocks, but
I'm the experiment leader, so.
You probably know that from the 80s, this massage things or this training thingies. I tried that. It's like the iPod of pain.
Ausprobiert übrigens bis Stufe 8. Das Gerät hat 25 Stufen.
He tried up to level 8. It has 25 levels, and at 8 he said, that's enough. So that's where we're going to start above 10 this time.
What do you think from here to here?
Aber du bist Rechtshänder, ne? Ich würde links machen, dann bist du meinst auch in einem...
You're a lefty, right? You're a righty, so I do it on the left-hand side. Oh, while you set up these electrodes appropriately, I can read out what I found out about Monster. Maybe it'll, you know, raise your appetite, young Padawan. The Monster, for a lot of cheese newbies, it's the horror par excellence. It varies between old sock and young cow, and it's always intense and special.
Mm-hmm.
And you really don't appreciate how I'm offering you amazing cheese here.
The worst is if I start it, then it's already working, so it's already vibrating. You could put one finger one there and one there.
So to start getting into the mood.
We can also do like that. I also put one of these stickers on your arm and then we are out of the hands. Come on, just once.
Just once for a short time.
And then I'm going to suffer alone. I have to turn that off first.
So, jetzt ist aus.
Okay, now it's turned off.
Wir spüren nichts,
we don't feel anything as we are not touching.
Group pressure is really bad when there's 4,000 people in front of you.
Da kommt gar nichts.
There's nothing here.
Oh. Ernsthaft?
Seriously? That was too much.
Way too much. I'm very sorry.
Das waren jetzt 15.
That was 15.
Oh.
Entschuldigung.
Also, sorry.
Also, das finde ich wirklich unmenschlich, deswegen machen wir das nur an dir.
Ja. That's really inhumane, so we're just doing that to you.
Yeah, I'm still sorry. That wasn't my intention. But it was okay-ish.
So, was ist jetzt? 15 oder...
So, what you're gonna do? 15 or trying that?
15 or once? I tried.
Alter.
Dude. Schlimmer, oder? It's going to be worse, isn't it?
Ah, der ist...
Oh, no. Do we have...
Der ist temperiert für dich.
It's temperated just for you. 4 days in my trunk.
Boah. Du riechst aus dem Mund.
You're smelling.
Das ist widerlich. Vergiss es. Hier kommt die zweite Stufe.
Boah.
Schau dir mal diesen Weichkäse an. Das ist der Rebluchon, s'il vous plaît, Monsieur.
Ja, Moment.
Ich muss das kurz ausspülen.
Na. So. Ja.
Also wenn du so verzweifelt bist, dass du Wasserstoffperoxid gurgeln würdest, dann würde ich von weiteren Experimenten... Nein, das machen wir natürlich nicht. So, Reblochon, s'il vous plaît. Das ist der französische Rohmilchkäse für alle, denen der Munster nicht heftig genug ist. Ich hatte so den Eindruck, du könntest ganz, noch was Deftiges...
Mal ganz ehrlich, ne, das von gerade tut mir leid, aber du schuldest mir was hier nach.
Majestätisch streng sind Geruch und Geschmack, Aromen von Kräutern und Abbeize vereinen sich bis hin zu bisweilen scharfem Ammoniak. Krieg ich mal Lust auf mehr, würde ich sagen. So, oh, meine Finger riechen. Das nimmst du aber wie ein... Ist gut.
Im Gegensatz zum ersten ist ja okay.
Okay.
Der Münster war schlimmer.
Das war Stufe 1 von 3.
Was? Ich dachte, das war 1 und 2.
Naja, ich sehe, deine Schwäche ist nicht der Käse. Deswegen habe ich noch andere Lebensmittel mitgebracht.
Ich gucke mal, wie schmerzhaft das hier ist.
Und das nächste ist toll, finde ich. Warte mal. Ich muss sagen, ich habe eine gewisse Faszination für dieses Lebensmittel.
Also so bis... Oh Gott. Also bis... Ah, nee, 12 ist fies. Das geht bis 25. Alter, wer tut sich das denn an?
So, das nächste Lebensmittel ist Haggis.
Oh, nee, voll nee.
Jetzt warte doch erstmal ab. Aber immer gleich ablehnen, ne?
Könntest der Remfort. Warte mal, könntest du mein Notebook ein bisschen davon? Ich weiß, du hast mein Buch nicht gelesen, ne? Aber du hast nicht Surströmming oder so.
Ja, aber das sieht ein bisschen aus wie Katzenfutter.
Also Haggis, man kann ja, klar, man kann wieder Remford gleich wieder ablehnen und so negativ, aber man muss eigentlich die konzeptionelle Reinheit von Haggis muss man schon wertschätzen. Haggis ist im Prinzip ein Schaf, was sich selbst gegessen hat.
Es ist nämlich, das nennt man Aufopferung, ne?
Es ist nämlich ein Schafmagen, in dem Schafleber, Schafherz und Schaflunge abgefüllt wurde. Würdest du das essen?
Nein, da bin ich raus.
Echt?
Da bin ich raus, definitiv.
15?
20.
Würdest du nicht?
Nee, würde ich nicht.
Ja, dann bitte mal einen Stromschlag.
15?
15. Ja, man muss ja schon ein bisschen auch prüfen, wie ernst es dir mit deiner Abneigung ist.
Sehr, dabei sehr. So. Das könnte schmerzhaft werden. Warum muss ich eigentlich immer leiden?
Ich gehe schon mal zur Seite.
Das zittert.
Zert bitte bereit machen.
Guck mal. Oh, 15 ist echt fies.
Du stehst da so sehr mit 15.
Oh, stopp.
Na, warte mal mit 20. Wir haben ja noch eine Teststufe, eine Produktgruppe habe ich vorbereitet.
Bei 15 kann ich meinen Arm nicht mehr gerade halten.
Das geht nach 2 Tagen wieder weg. Pass auf, warten wir mal noch. Schalt schon mal auf 20.
Das geht ja direkt los, wenn man.
Also, dann lass erst mal noch einen Moment auf 15.
Ich hab aus. Sonst würde ich hier so stehen.
Ich habe mit dem Herrn Remford schon viel.
Möchtest du?
Ich habe mit dem Herrn Remford schon.
Haggis oder 15? Ernsthaft?
Haggis oder 15, dann nehme ich Haggis. Die ganze Dose. Nein.
Ernsthaft? Haggis? Boah, Respekt.
Ja. Wo war die Flasche zum Nachspülen?
Da unten.
Oh,
das ist fies.
So, Alter, jetzt kriegst du.
Bei Fisch bin ich übrigens raus.
Ich habe mit dem Herrn Remford schon viel erlebt. Wir haben auch Reisen gemacht. In manchen Reisen kommt man sich sehr nahe. Das war unsere Indienreise. Und in so Reisen, bei so Reisen, ich habe Lunge zwischen den Zähnen. Bei so Reisen spricht man auch über Ekel. Und der Herr Remford hat mir mal anvertraut, dass seine Toleranz gegenüber Lebensmitteln bei Insekten aufhören würde.
Oh.
Sag mal, das war ein Fehler vielleicht. Ich habe hier dieses Sortiment. Oh, das Bier ist umgekippt.
Natürlich, ja, super. Klar. Welches Bier?
Ich habe dieses Sortiment an Lebens-, nein, nicht lebend, Insekten, aber an Insekten bestellt für dich. Und du könntest jetzt, würdest,
guck mal, die bewegen sich noch?
Nein, die bewegen sich nicht, aber es sieht fast so aus, ja.
Bin ich raus. Bin ich raus, vollkommen. Das, nee.
Würde ich sagen 20, ja. 20?
Ich nehme alles, bevor ich irgendwas davon. Weil ich glaube, ich müsste brechen. Also, die gehen gar nicht.
Was findest du das Ekligste davon?
Also, damit habe ich meine Ratte früher gefüttert. Die.
Echt?
Ja.
Pass auf, ich opfer mich für dich. Wie so oft. Kriege ich gar nicht auf, ja.
Boah, der Käse ist. Also, wenn einer von euch nachher mal Käse probieren möchte.
Gib mir mal ein Messer oder so.
Warte.
Ah, super, danke. Also hier so eine Heuschrecke. Was sagst du dazu?
Super eklig. Ernsthaft? Nee, dann bin ich raus.
Wer hat Bock auf Heuschrecke?
Oh. Ja, ich weiß, es gibt Kulturkreise, wo das als Snack gegessen wird, aber da bin ich raus.
Gib mal durch. Ich wollte schon immer mal sowas sagen wie, wer bekommt die Mehlwürmer? Aber nicht alles alleine essen, gib das mal ein bisschen durch. Du kannst schon mal das nächste Thema machen.
Ja, das. Ich befreie mich mal kurz von. Autsch! Das schlimmer als.
Das ist schlimmer ein bisschen
als die fies. Stromschläge sind tatsächlich das Zeug von der Haut abzureißen. So. Das nächste Thema. Es kommen ja noch ein paar Nobelpreise und ich hänge
am Kaugummi.
So. Während der Herr Wörl die Knabbereien unters Volk bringt.
Oh, ich habe eine Heuschrecke zwischen den Zähnen.
Boah, ist das eklig.
Dreck neben Haggis. Lunge,
ne? Ja, das finde ich wirklich hochgradig ekelhaft. Wahrnehmung.
Perception. There was an Ig Nobel Prize in the topic of perception. And that's really close to my own heart, because it's a concept I can understand very well. I don't think it's been dealt with enough, even though it's been dealt with more lately. In this study, it was shown that identical twins cannot distinguish between each other visually. When identical twins see photographs of their own and their twins' faces, they don't have an easier time recognizing their own picture than others. Normally, humans can immediately recognize themselves on a picture, and identical twins kind of lose this ability immediately. I mean, they can recognize themselves sometimes, but it takes them some time. And they did that with like 10, 20 people. It's kind of tricky to find identical twin couples if you want to do a study with them. And okay, so to show you what this means, this is the example that went through the media, where twins cannot recognize themselves. There was a very, very prominent example here, particularly here in the area. Bernd Höcke, he is very afraid of the Black Peter. It's a German expression. And his problem was that in he was hardly distinguishable from Björn Höcke, who doesn't like concrete cubes. And they had a really hard time distinguishing between each two. But it got really complicated. These two you could deal with, but it got really tricky when a third person got involved, who really is not involved with the twins, but you could almost confuse him with them. And Bernd and Björn had to fight with that. And there was a third guy called Landor Vladik, not Bernd nor Björn Höcke. And in his, well, he wasn't that young, and he wrote for the NPD. But completely different person, no relation whatsoever. And even in public, you would see people who can not distinguish themselves from their twins, and there are revenants who have absolutely nothing to do with these twins because they're Nazis. And the twins, well, they're Nazis too, but in blue, so.
Okay, we müssen ein bisschen vorwärts
machen. Okay, we have to accelerate a little bit. We only have 5 minutes left, so let's start about fluid dynamics. Second last. It was for studying the dynamics of liquid sloshing when a person is walking backwards by carrying a cup of coffee. It's also important for mankind, but.
Und hier zeigen wir mal, wie wir unsere Stärke als Service-Podcast.
And here we are showing how good we are in Service-Podcast. It's actually it's about the fact, if you are walking in your office from the coffee machine to your working desk, that you splash your coffee. And that's how the paper is starting.
Ein wirklich wundervolles Paper.
It's a really amazing paper. The first.
We managed to carry coffee around without spilling.
I can't read that. I'm sorry.
Dieses Bild ist tatsächlich in dem Paper drin.
This is actually a picture from the paper. It's a proof. So, oh yes, coffee is actually doing this.
The very commonness of the phenomenon, we tend to dismiss questioning it beyond simple exclaiming, Jenkins, you have too much coffee in your cup. Und die Wissenschaftler sagen,
and scientists say, no, It's not only a question of the amount, it's also other things which are important. So, first investigation, you have two different shapes of the glass. On the left-hand side, you see a little mechanical manipulator. It is to have a frequency in the glass. So in the top row, A and B, there you have 2 hertz, and in the bottom, 4 hertz. And you see that the liquid is behaving differently. It's supposed to have coffee, but depending on the shape of the glass, it's behaving different, especially for the coffee cup. So the picture on the left-hand side, it's very dramatically for 4 hertz. And the scientists have investigated why is it actually that frequency. So they have done the calculations. So the reason is, or at least I think, you're walking with your coffee, and then your steps is transmitting a frequency to the cup. And if this frequency is close to the resonance frequency of the fluid, then it's shaking heavily, and the coffee is splashing over the cup. So, and then we wanted to see where is the frequency, the resonance frequency. And they found that for usual coffee cups, 5 centimeters, or radius 5 centimeters, then you have this frequency is close to 3 or 4 hertz. So what I've seen in experiment is actually what you've calculated. That's why I have more experiments.
Beschleunigungssensoren.
They have used sensors for acceleration, as you can see on the left-hand side with their smartphones. They had a closer look. So how is actually the coffee cups washing around? And they could actually tell apart the X direction, the Z direction, and the Y direction. And using Fourier transformation, they could actually find that there is a frequency close to the frequency of resonance. So this 4 hertz. Now we have the question, and that's our point of a service podcast. I think you want to know, how can you avoid that splashing? So one solution is, there are actually 2 solutions. First of all, you have to change the frequency of resonance. That's hard if you have just a regular coffee cup. Or you have to change the frequency of the walking. And this is when we walk backwards.
Of course, walking backwards, also das war der Vorschlag, rückwärts laufen. Of course, walking backwards may be less of a practical method to prevent coffee spilling than a mere physical speculation. A few trials will soon reveal that walking backwards, much more than suppressing resonance, drastically increases the chances of tripping on a stone or crashing into a passing by a colleague who may also be walking backwards.
Ich. So you said that walking backwards drastically increases the chance to collide with a wall or a colleague.
So the PhD student who actually catch me googling for dildos has also seen me walking backwards.
Naja, gut. Schauen wir mal, wie es ist, wenn ich wieder von der Arbeit komme.
So, let's see. So that's the first solution. It's not as practical. The second one is how to handle it. So you only have the body and the cup. So it's a very sort of thing. You have a couple system. So hand, cup, hand, body. So there is a coupling.
Grundsätzlich die Tasse so zu halten ist schon mal eine ganz gute Idee.
Apparently holding the cup like this, if it's not too hot, is a good idea, but you can optimize that further. So if you hold the cup like that, you have like a pendulum, and this pendulum has a different resonance frequency. So we can actually this starting resonance
einbringe, können wir
from walking, we can actually change that.
Des ganzen Systems ändern.
We can change the whole resonance frequency. The best thing is if you change the pendulum. So for example with this thing, it can do really amazing things. So in the cup it's full of water and I can really walk very fast. I'm not sure why I should do this, but I could if I wanted to.
Zweite Lösung für euch.
Second solution.
This looks like you are.
Do you want a coffee?
Yeah, looks like you're working at church.
So it's the second solution. The third solution
is the latte effect. Den hatten wir auch mal in
der. Is the so-called latte effect? We just put some foam on top of the solid, then it's splashing less. That's a technical solution. So in big tanks, you can actually put this foam on top. On the fourth solution,
that's by beer schon eingebaut.
By the way, that's built in when you talk about beer, so that's amazing.
The king of the liquids.
Vierte Lösung ist.
Fourth solution is.
Vierte Lösung ist,
wir haben already mentioned that coffee and a cup has a specific resonance frequency, so we can change the resonance frequency if we change the radius of the cup. So on the left hand side, we have constructed a new cup. It's built from small cups. And there is the frequency, resonance frequency is not at close to 4. It would be somewhere at 12.
Are they connected?
Ja, dann, genau.
Well, if they wouldn't be connected.
So, that was food dynamics. We have something very quickly. Oh, economics.
Yeah, we can do this really quickly because it's about economics. How does the contact to a living crocodile influence your influence how much you want to gamble? The result is nice here. They took people who were on a crocodile farm and who were able to hold a living crocodile, and they were these people were asked before and after if they want to do gambling, well, for example, on a slot machine, and they found out that people who had contact with a crocodile were more risk affine, so they wanted to gamble more. If
positive Erfahrungen damit machen, generell, also beim Spielen. Bei Leuten, die Spielprobleme haben,
führt es
eher, dass die Leute diese Aufregung halt damit verwechseln, also mit ihrer Aufregung sonst beim Spielen verwechseln.
Wenn
sie eher negative Erinnerungen ans Spielen haben, dass sie dann...
You want to gamble more if you have a positive connection with gambling, but if you have a gambling problem, contact with crocodile, after a contact with crocodile, you want to gamble less. So the result was the excitement you get from meeting a crocodile, you cannot really disconnect from this excitement of gambling. And so crocodile excitement, you can do this. And there is this famous child game called Crocodoc. And here they substituted the upper row of teeth with knives. And yeah, this is exciting. This kind of raises the stakes.
Beachte das Pflaster.
Yeah, and as you see, one guy already has. Yeah, this thing is quick. I remember like a children's show on RTL, I think. So where they had this crocodile thing
without the knife,
scaled up like 20 times, but of course without knives. But yeah, this is exciting, right? And you know how it is. It's always the last one. Well, if it's the last one, you're prepared.
Antesten.
Well, let's test first.
Man will nicht tauschen, oder?
You don't want to switch with them, right?
Stimmt, wir hätten das einfach machen sollen vor dem Blutexperiment.
We should have done that before the blood experiment.
Also wirklich schnell, fieses Teil.
It's really quick, it's really mean.
Leute leiden da mehr als wenn wir.
You see, people are more for this game as we even have for ourselves here.
Ouch. And look at the angry look, the evil look of the crocodile.
It came a long way, I would say. So, thank you very much. We have to stop now. And we would like to start with the master of ceremony for the Ig Nobel Prizes. Is always concluding with the same sentence. He always says, if you haven't won an Ig Nobel Prize this year, and furthermore, if you have won one, good luck next year. Thank you very much for being here that early. Wait a second. There's one more thing you would like to present. It's an experiment for the end. Because we thought, if this fails, we can just skip it.
Yeah. We have one last thing. Well, I have one last thing. We do one more experiment.
Ich glaube, ich war noch nie so nervös.
I was never this nervous before. One last experiment, which is one of the most exciting experiments we ever did. Well, I ever did. And this has a long history. Maybe you remember last year on the Congress. there was this paper, Wanted the Omnious Woman. We didn't hang this up, somebody else put this up. Whoever this was, I laughed a lot. And this year on the Congress you saw these posters. We were asked by many people, we were told by many people, these posters are cool, but we didn't make these, but whoever made these, please talk to us. I love them a lot.
AliExpress und Lipin. Da fehlt eigentlich nur noch die Bewuta IT. Und also ich fand's großartig.
I liked it a lot.
Viele Leute, die gefragt haben, so ja, wer ist denn?
Many people asked who is the Omnious Woman.
Ich habe die ominöse Frau halt gefunden.
The Omnious Woman, I found her
in ihrer natürlichen Umgebung,
in her natural environment on while traveling.
Ja, Blick, die ominöse Frau ist sehr scheu, wie man sieht. Sie hat wie ein Rehkitz in die Scheinwerfer geguckt.
This is a photo of her. She's very shy. She looked into the camera like a doe.
Das tut mir auch super, super leid. Und damit ihr das, weil sie sitzt hier im Publikum, und damit ihr das weniger...
She's in the audience and...
Fotos noch von mir.
And so, for her... In order for her to not so that this is not as embarrassing for her, I'm going to show embarrassing photos of me. Here on left side I am in boxer shorts, on the right side this is my on the right side that was and this is me after a night of drinking, and if I'm not waking up next to the Omnious Woman, I'm waking up next to my cat. And as you know, the highlights of embarrassing photos, well, I had a lot of embarrassing photos, but you have to take a closer look to see why this is embarrassing. And yeah, you're going to continue now. If you have a cat, you're never alone. You never shit alone.
Wie man im Hintergrund an den Kacheln sieht, ist das ein Klo.
As you see in the background, this is a toilet shot.
Ich hoffe, dass das ausreichend peinlich war, dass der...
I hope this is embarrassing enough, so that the Omnious Woman is not as embarrassed. Because most of the time the Omnious Woman looks quite nice on pictures. I like her a lot and I love her a lot.
Sie ist nämlich abgesehen davon, dass sie wunderhübsch.
Aside from being very beautiful, she's also very silly. There are also photos like this.
Die sie mir gelegentlich schickt und ich lache jedes Mal und.
She occasionally sends these to me and I laugh and my heart is skipping a bit. And I don't think I will ever meet a person anymore who excites me so much.
Wunderschöne Dame, die Pizza.
And this is why. I wanted to ask if this wonderful woman who loves pizza as much as me, sometime she told me that I want always to stay together with you. I know you like diamonds, but I would also take a ring made of aluminum foil. And
Der Ring ist in halbmaschineller Fertigung entstanden.
This is this ring was made in half with machine. And you ever told me if I propose, you told me if I ever propose, I should tell your full name. So, Sanko Utu Manisen, do you want to marry me?
case anyone can't see it, she said yes. There is huge applause, standing ovation.
Everyone is happy, and congratulations also from the translating team.
Vielen Dank, dass ihr dabei wart.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Schicken wir die beiden, mal gucken, ob der passt.
Let's see whether the ring fits. All right, I think
okay, it's
we should
also
sign
time
off.
To conclude for us, thank you for listening to Methodisch Incorrect, Methodically Wrong. This has been translated by Marianne Shanks and Frau Blauwal, and we're always happy about your feedback. Please send it to us using @StreetVLingo or #CStreetT on Twitter.
And we apologize for the interruption in the middle. There were technical issues that we sadly could not do anything about.
Die Zugabe könnt eigentlich nur ihr machen im Endeffekt. Also von daher schickt die beiden in einen wirklich schönen Abschied.
Puh.